Hi, I'm Sarah Sellers, and this is Carbon Markets 101, where we will be answering the question, what is a carbon credit? With the changing policy environment and growing concern about climate change, many people are talking about how to reduce greenhouse gas emissions. Carbon credits are one way to do this, and agriculture can be an important generator of carbon credits. A carbon credit is a tradable certificate representing the right to emit one metric ton of carbon dioxide or the equivalent amount of another greenhouse gas. It's a way to quantify carbon sequestration. Companies who want to offset their greenhouse gas emissions can purchase carbon credits to do this. There are two types of markets, voluntary and compliance. In a compliance market, a cap and trade system is used where the government tells each company how much it's allowed to pollute, and if the company wants to pollute more than this amount, they must purchase carbon credits to offset this additional pollution. In a voluntary market, companies voluntarily purchase carbon credits to offset their emissions, likely to reach net zero emissions goals set by their company or by their stakeholders. The U.S. market is voluntary, but some states have cap and trade systems for certain emitters. You may be wondering, what is the difference between carbon dioxide and a carbon dioxide equivalent? A carbon dioxide equivalent puts greenhouse gases into a common unit based on their global warming potential and the amount of time it takes the gas to leave the atmosphere. For example, when looking at a 100-year period, nitrous oxide has a global warming potential 265 to 298 times that of carbon dioxide, so this is factored in when converting the gas to a standard unit. Putting everything into a standard unit allows for easy comparison between different greenhouse gases. Everything is put to terms of carbon dioxide because carbon dioxide is the most commonly released greenhouse gas caused by human activities, and it has the largest total impact on global warming. Carbon sequestration is the process of capturing and storing atmospheric carbon dioxide. The place where the carbon dioxide is stored is called a carbon sink. There are two main types of carbon sequestration, geologic and biologic. Geologic involves storing carbon dioxide in underground rock formations, while biologic involves storing carbon dioxide in plants, trees, soils, and aquatic environments. Agriculture and forestry can contribute to biologic sequestration through the storage of carbon dioxide in trees, plants, soils, and by reducing emissions. For example, a farmer could reduce or change the timing of their nitrogen applications to reduce nitrous oxide emissions. Carbon credits represent one metric ton of carbon dioxide or the equivalent amount of another greenhouse gas, and they are a unit that will be traded in carbon markets. In this video, we covered what carbon credits are, and how agriculture can contribute to carbon sequestration.